Hey guys, it's Pastor A here. I am coming to you with another reading, a revelation, and I was, you know, like we all do, we pray to God and He always gives us revelation because He's always speaking still today. So today, as you can see, the title is, If Prayer Isn't Working, Then Try This. You have to testify. You have to testify. There are biblical principles that you have to follow. And one of them is testifying. And so if you feel like the enemy is just at you and you can't get through, it's like no mountain, no giant, no valley, no hill. And you're like, what is it? I don't feel a resistance, but I just know it's not, he's not moving. Nothing is shaking in this area. Well, then try considering testifying. And you're like, well, I'll testify when it happens, when he's gone or when I feel better or when I get my breakthrough or, but your breakthrough is, let's dive into the word. Now I'm on my exercise bike here, but it's Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11. And it says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. And we know that's Jesus Christ. And by the word of their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto death. So it says, and by the word of their testimony. So you overcome by the words of your testimony. You overcome the enemy. The overcome the enemy, you are an overcomer when you testify. So you're like, what do I testify of if this is my problem? Testify what God did before. You know he's done something before. And if you are a person who can't see the goodness of God in your life and what he's doing, or you feel like you don't have a testimony, then I pray right now your eyes are open. Because for this, for some breakthroughs, for some things for you to overcome and things get out of your way and for you to move forward and forward progression, you have to testify. So for this to work, what we're talking about today, for this revelation, you have to be able to see Jesus Christ. You have to be able. And if you don't have a testimony, you can't remember, you're new to salvation, and you're like, oh my goodness, that alone right there is a testimony. You're saved. Run and tell that. Tell everybody. Tell other people's testimonies. Listen to them, how God overcame. You might meet somebody who is struggling with infertility and you know of a testimony of somebody else who got healed or delivered or now has a baby and you're like, hey, I know of a person. Testify. It's just that simple. Testify. Because you overcame. It says we have overcome by the word of our testimonies. So you have to have something to testify to get through this next thing so you can have a testimony. And it's like, he'll do it this time. It's done this time because he did it last time. So you just have to testify. And then some other scriptures, let us go into them. Which are, and I'm just going to let you know that you are an overcomer. What is an overcomer? What benefits you have as an overcomer? When you testify, these things belong to you. And 1 John 4:4 says, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. Who is them? If you're overcoming something, it's something in your way, right? You've overcome them. You've surpassed them. You're above them. It says, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And you know, the enemy, this is the world belongs, is his, right? Till Jesus Christ comes back. We are here in this world. Jesus didn't remove us out of this world. So 1 John 5:4 says, for whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. Can you see that? Whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. You're born of God. Testify. You are an overcomer. You have to tell it. You have to tell it. You can't keep it a secret. You can't be embarrassed, because if you're embarrassed of God and what he's done for you, you don't want nobody to know. I had herpes. Yes, I did. I was a prostitute. Yes, I was. But what has God done? I tell the world. I have the black and white medical reports. The same doctors that said I had herpes were the same ones to say, hey, you don't. My blood is clean. Prostitution, deliver. not out there running after that anymore. So at the end of the day, but I testify, I've overcome. It's no way I can go back to it. No way herpes is be in this body anymore. No more will I ever live that life of prostitution and flirtation and chasing a dollar through my with my body. No, never, 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 never. Impossible. Why? I've testified. I testify, and it's not a secret anymore. Our next scripture is what I got here, Revelations chapter 2 and verse 17. And it says, "He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the hidden manna." Can you imagine? There is food out there for you that is hidden. And it says, "Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God." So there is hidden manna. So not only are you living on natural food to sustain yourself, you're also living on that manna, that hidden manna, that food for your spirit, that food for your soul. And it's hidden. It's revelatory. It's revelation. You talk to God, it's no longer hidden. He's feeding you. Your spirit is growing. You're becoming this giant in the spirit. All of heaven knows you. The enemy sees you and trembles. He knows. When I want to pray, that's it. It's done. It's over. Leave her alone. It's, you know, something you just keep the enemy at bay just by these simple biblical principles. And it says, "And I will give him a white stone, and in the stone a new name." Sometimes your name might mean something that needs to be changed, just like Peter was from Cephas to Peter, you know. And look at the many names of Jesus, how we know him as Emmanuel, Jehovah, Jesus, God is with, like so many different names. But what are people calling you when, as a prostitute, I had a name. But when it came down to business, what was it? It was money at the end of the day. That's what it was. That's what the services was rendered, and that's what it was known for. No longer am I being called a prostitute. When someone walks up on me, they're not talking. My spirit isn't talking to them and translating that like, "Hey, she easy," or "Hey, she's not wife material," or "Hey, she's been with..." No, that those titles follow me no more. My name is Pastor Alwanza. This is what God calls me. This is what the name has been given to me by my spiritual parents, Prophet Hubert Angel and Prophetess BB Angel. I am known in heaven as Pastor Alwanza. That is my name. My first name is Pastor. We gonna start there, okay? Alwanza means victory. My middle name is Victorious. My middle name is Victory. Means victory as well. Like I have already, well, Victorious and Victory. It's both of my names. It's I can't fail. So what are people calling you? Learn what your name means. And if you don't like it, change it. It's just that simple. But with God in Christ, as you testify, you are an overcomer. God has given you a name. And if it's, you feel like it's, you should be called something else, pray to him about it. What is this new name that he has given you? It may just need, you need the power and backing of the name that you already have. That's it. You just need to be acknowledged by the name that you have, with power and authority to know and speak it with confidence. We are overcomers. Now, the next one is 2 and 26, Revelation. "And he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations." Now, can a nation be born in a day? I am a nation. You are a nation. Everybody you see at the mall, at the park, they are nations, individuals, nations. And it says, Abraham, many nations are in him, are in us. We are nations. So when it says, "To him will I give power over the nations," your enemy, everybody that's around you that doesn't belong or needs subduing, they, the animals, it doesn't matter. Because of who you are, you've testified, you are an overcomer, you have overcome the enemy. Jesus already defeated him on the cross, but you have to pay your part. You have to testify of how Jesus died on the cross has done it for you. Do you understand? So you have power. keep your works to the end. Don't deny the faith. Don't lose faith. Don't lose hope. Stay confident. Stay prayed up. Continue to talk to God. Stay happy. Find some affirmations. Look at my affirmation wall. And I'm working on different areas of my house still, where in my bathroom, my closet area, my kitchen, like, I'm still affirmations everywhere. Because so is a man thinking in his heart, so is he. And if these words are flooding me, I'm telling you, keep it positive, keep it positive, keep it positive. And the enemy ain't got time, he ain't got no space to come in, give him no place. And so the next one is Revelation 3:21. To him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne. You know, Jesus Christ sits on the throne. He says, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. You are an overcomer. The moment you start testifying, you have a seat. You have a seat. These are biblical principles. Biblical principles. God said, we are in his hands and nobody can pluck us out. These are biblical principles. And our last one is 21:7, Revelation. And it says, he that overcometh shall inherit all things. I will be his God and he shall be my son. You are a child of the living God. Don't ever, ever, ever forget it. Jesus loves you. And if you need any merchandise, you can DM me and let me know. I personally made Jesus Loves Me t-shirts, just like I made this one. You can check it out, toyistees.org. See all the merchandise over there as well. You are a son of the living God and Jesus loves you. Don't ever, ever, ever forget it. And it says, he that overcometh shall inherit all things. What are you trying to possess, but this thing is blocking you? Something is in your way. If something is in your way, start testifying. If you don't have, you're trying to get a testimony right now, speak of the things that he's already done for you. Testify. You have to testify. That's the way this biblical principle works. Testify, 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 and you overcome. It's that simple. I love you guys, and these scriptures I'll put down below. Also, if check out the store, toyistees.org, and definitely like, subscribe, and follow for more. Yes, Sophia's here. She is sleeping, so I'm on her time schedule right now trying to squeeze this in. Definitely follow me at Alwanza on Instagram and Toya Tees on Facebook. You also can find me over there. All right, guys. Well, I love you, and as always, I am who I am because my spiritual parents answered the call on their life. Prophet Hubert Angel and Prophetess BB Angel. So therefore, Spirit Embassy. If you don't have a church, join Spirit Embassy. Contact me, DM me, let me know that you're looking for one, whatever area you're in. I'll let you know and upgrade your life. Upgrade your life. And just upgrade your life. So love you guys. And until next time, see you. Bye.